Hello everyone, welcome to Paper Craft Mix. It's me, Brigitta, and I'm so excited for today's video because I'm going to show you the gorgeous Maggie Holmes swap I received from Wendy, my sweet creative life, here on YouTube and over on Instagram. A few days ago I showed you everything I sent to her, and yesterday I received the beautiful box with goodies from her. And yeah, I was really, really spoiled by her. She really made gorgeous things and gave me beautiful items. I did open a few packages because my daughter really wanted to see what was on the inside of the gifts. But a lot of the items I did not open. I did open the box because my daughter wants to see it. And I saw that the embellishment box that we agreed on, it opened during shipping. So I needed to find all the little doodads that she put into this out of the box with the beautiful big heaps of shred and everything gorgeous that she put in it. So I have seen a lot of the items from the outside, but I did not open it except for the gift. So yeah, I did put everything back. The first thing I'm going to tease you with is this gorgeous junk journal she made for me. I am going to show this in a separate video because you see it. It's a chunky monkey, and this video will be too long if I show this also in this video. So this will be a separate video, but isn't it gorgeous? I challenged her to do a junk journal. I made a mini one for her because I thought it's her first journal swap. What did she do? She made a full-size, super duper large junk journal for me. It's gorgeous. But again, I'm going to show this in a separate video. So I have the box right beside me because there is a lot of stuff in it. And yeah, let's start. The first thing I want to show you is this cute, cute little coffee cup that she made for me. I recognize it. It's a die from KS Crafts. The same day that this swap arrived to me, my KS Craft order arrived, and I have ordered the die for the one size bigger cup, and now I see how I can make it. So I'm really, really happy to receive this. I think it's so cute. She decorated it really beautiful with the chipboard pieces from the Garden Party collection. She used Garden Party for everything, I believe, except for the journal. That's a Minté collection. And here is the lid, also really cute, with a beautiful butterfly with diamond dots in the middle. Paper flowers, I just love it. And what's on the inside are some gorgeous flowers. We also agreed on doing some flowers for each other. And look, she made gorgeous vellum flowers for me. And for my challenge entry, I already received some beautiful flowers as well. And now she made more. This is gorgeous embossed vellum paper that she used. And I did think she inked the middle parts herself with ink. I think it's beautiful. So gorgeous. And here are the other one, vellum flowers. Wow. Oh, and I didn't say it. Do you have a cup of coffee or tea or a snack prepared? Because I think this will be quite a long video. This is still a smaller one. And here we have other ones. And here she combined it with vellum and glitter cardstock. I love, love, love them. They are so, so beautiful. Thank you, Wendy. I really love these flowers. You know that I made a lot of flowers the last few weeks, but these are really different ones. And that's so nice. Everyone makes different flowers, even if they have the same kind of dyes for it. So, yeah, it's so cute to see. Then we go to this sweet little box. Look. She used one of my favorite sheets from the Garden Party. I love this dark sheet. She added pompon trim around it. And on top is this thing. I'm lost for the English word now, but you see what it is. I think it's really cute. She puts a lot of tiny sprigs and flowers on the inside. So cute. It's a wheelbarrow. For the wheel, she added this really dimensional flat bag with gold specks in it. Really gorgeous. Again, a tiny sentiment and a beautiful butterfly with diamond dots. This one opens like this, and let's take a look what's on the inside. Oh, I think I see some glitter. Yes, I love glitter. Let us see. I'm going to close the box. really careful. Oh, I can of course put it here and you can still see it a little bit. And she added some glitters for me. Imagine in glitter, and I do not have my reading glasses on, so I cannot read which brand it is, but it's a beautiful silver glitter. Beautiful black with gorgeous color specks in it. And a gorgeous yellow. Oh, I love this one. So beautiful. It's called Melted Butter. Yeah, it really looks like melted butter. Beautiful. Thank you, Andy. I can for sure use this. Then we go to this box. I'm so intrigued by this. I did not open this box. It's really hefty. And it's really sturdy made. Can you see it? The chipboard, and yeah, I still have some confetti, I see. She decorated the front with a double shaker. The banner here in the background is a shaker. Look how cute, with vellum, or with organza. Love it. The tiniest bow she glued on here. So adorable. She made a beautiful butterfly shaker from KS Crafts. Loved it. So adorable. She put flowers into the middle of the body of the butterfly. Here again, some layering of die cuts. Love it. Small heart here. So beautiful. And let's open it. It closes with a seam binding. When we open it up. Ah, look, it's a memo note stack. Wow, this is a beautiful one. Now I have a beautiful notepad here in my craft room. I love it. Gorgeous. Thank you, Andy. I really like this. This will look so awesome on my desk. I will for sure keep it on my desk. It's too beautiful. Thank you. Then I will start with some of the gifts. Here is a cute bag, and I think she does as me. She reuses the bags that she receives from her crafty friends. She made a cute bag topper. It's the bow bag topper. With the heart, and it says XOXO, for sure going to keep it. And she attached a beautiful dangle. I hope you can see it. I always think it's hard to show these on camera. On the bulldog clip, she attached this. It's a cute bead dangle with hug. Really tiny heart, beautiful, gorgeous beads, and a beautiful heart again. Cabochon with the flake. I really love this with the flakes in the, on the inside of the resin. So beautiful. So that came with this back topper. And let's see what she puts on the inside. I did see this already because, as I already told you, my daughter was so curious. And the first thing is this beautiful laser cut chipboard from Snip Art. I've never heard of them. But look how beautiful and how beautiful cut this is. I really love it. Branches with birds. I can so use this on almost any project. I love it. Thank you, Andy. I'm really happy with this one. She included a beautiful sticker sheet from Pink Fresh Studio. Puffy stickers. I love to use those. And these one go with every summer collection, I think. Beautiful. Thank you. And here she gifted me some papers. And I'm going to take it out because I'm so curious. Because this is a music sheet. And it looks like it is really vintage. Yeah, I think it is. Or yeah, I think it's printed, but I really love it. Or is it a sticker? Oh, wait. I think it's a sticker sheet. I'm not sure. I really love this. Look how beautiful it is. Totally vintage. Gorgeous. Thank you, Andy. I can use this in a journal. And now I have received your gorgeous journal and you get such a small one for me. You will for sure get another junk journal for me in the future. I can't promise when, but it will be on my list for you. Here is another cute bag. With a gorgeous bag topper. Look how beautiful this bag topper is. She used the cake from the collection. The flat bags from our local store. I recognize them. really beautiful. And the back got a little bit damaged in the nail. So I am going to try to take off the back topper after I've done the video, so I can keep it. Oh. I have the gift that was on the inside and some shred. But look, she gave me another one of her beautiful rainbows. I really love these. She already gifted one in hot pink on my challenge entry giveaway. Entry for my challenge giveaway. And I told her I loved it. And now she made a beautiful shabby one. I really, really love this. It's so gorgeous. Thank you, Wendy. This will get a beautiful place in my craft room. I forgot to show you, but this was a card that she did for me. That was on top of the box with her message to me. She used garden party paper and she layered vellum on top. Can you see it? It's a layer of printed vellum. I love it. She used some of the ephemeras from the garden party collection. She even used a wooden fence here with on front a cute bunny. I love it. And this is a tag with a beautiful flower cabochon. Yeah, I love it. Thank you, Wendy, for your cute card. Again, we'll go into my craft room. Here we have another bag with gifts. She decorated it really nicely with the cute fox from the garden party chipboards. And on the inside of this bag, she included some beautiful flower packs for me and some leaf ribbon trim. I really like this one. And I don't have a lot of it anymore, so I'm really happy with this. Thank you, Wendy. Then we go to the next. I saw this cute, cute felt bag. And then I flipped it and I saw it's Coco and Reno. So this is the packaging for a Coco and Reno dies or stamp kit. I'm not sure. And yeah, she used it to wrap something in. And I really like that. And yeah. This is a whole bag of ephemera that she did for me. And I will not show them all to you, but I will show a quick flip to this one. It's cute. It's like a photograph doily. Macaroons. The love of my life. You make me smile. Gorgeous flowers. Treasured moment. Yeah, you see it. It's a whole lot of diamonds. I cannot show them all to you because it's really too much. But I really like to use these on embellishments, on cards, on bag toppers, on packages for decoration, in journals. Well, it's just gorgeous. So it was in this cute Coco and Reno bag. Then we go to this baggie. Look how cute, it's an acrylic bag. She decorated the front with these beautiful trims and a bow with, again, a vellum flower. And on the inside, I have to look how this opens. Be careful. How does this work? I think I just need to pull it, but I have to be really really careful. I cannot open it with my long nails. My nails are far too long. But I can go there this week. So now I have to do this off camera. I cannot open it right now. But on the inside she has some beautiful tags for me. And some decorations on top. Look how cute it is. You can see it through the acrylic. I really, really love these embellishments. Gorgeous. Thank you. There we go. This is also included some rose gold heat active foil. I have to think about how I'm going to use this. I don't have the heat foil pen from for this, so I have to think about how I can use this. They have it at Action, I know, such kind of a pen, so maybe I should buy it and then I can try this out. Thank you. Also included some foil flake embellishments. I saw a video with someone making wax seals and they put this into the wax seal. So I am going to try that out. And this is also nice just on any card or mixed media project. So thank you, Wendy. She included some soft like pastels for me for hand lettering. So it has these different kind of tips in the beautiful colors. Love it, thank you. Here is another bag. Love this one. And on the inside she included some self-care items for me. She's Pretty Coconuts. It's a hair mask. Beautiful. Oh, these are glued together. Do the avocado eye sheet mask. And this is your One in a Melon lip mask. Thank you. So this will be a pampering night for me when I can use that. Here is another beautiful bag. And then we go to the handmade items again. Wendy, when I saw this, I was so happy. You know, I love to make flowers with dyes. And I don't have anything of this kind. These are beautiful layered flowers. I love this. I received some of them from people for my challenge entry. And I think they're just gorgeous. But Wendy, you do have to send me the link with pictures of this. So that I know how they should be put together. So that I have an example. But thank you. I'm really, really happy with these dyes. They are gorgeous. Then here we have a beautiful mylar bag. I love it. You have to tell me where you find this this mylar. I think it's so gorgeous. She added a ribbon dangle to the side. Look, so many layers, so beautiful. And on top she decorated it really cute with a bow, with tulle, the cute chicken from the chipboard set. Love it. There's even a vellum rosette behind the layers. Gorgeous. Now I have to check how I can open this. Oh, don't tell me I need to cut this apart to open this. No, please not. Oh no, I hear a Velcro. Ah, luckily. Because this I can reuse, of course. Well, I am going to hoard this packaging because it's just too gorgeous. Look, now you can see it a little bit better. Wow. Beautiful. And on the inside, oh, I think this is a banner. Oh, I have to be careful that I don't. Oh, this will look so cute in my craft room. It's a little bit hard to show on camera, but look, it's a banner. It's a quite a big banner with a lot of layered butterflies. Can you see it? Wow. She added cute beads between the layers. Here at the end, she added gorgeous butterfly beads. Ah, wow, this is so cute. And I do think I need to hang it like this. Yeah, of course. Wow. Oh, this looks so cute. Ooh, this will look so cute in my craft room. Look how gorgeous it is. She layered up the butterfly, several layers. This is, my girl, this is a lot of work. Wendy, this should be a lot of work. To punch out all of those butterflies, layer them together, string the beads. Well, it's beautiful. Thank you. Oh, this is so cute. I love it. Maybe if I put it like this. It's also a nice decoration on my table for this video. Wow. Now we go to the next thing. Again, gorgeous bag with a beautiful layer. Oh, wow. Is this, maybe this is this flower. Not sure if this is the same. If it is the same, then I already have an example. I love it. So many layers. Gorgeous. And let's look what's on the inside. Ah, the cotton candy shakers. Also KS Craft, I believe. We are all a big fan of that store. I just received an order today from them. Look, she made the garden party cotton candy shakers. I received a few ones from my friend Patricia, but never in the Maggie Holmes team, so I love this. And what a cute cabochon is this. I've never seen this. It's a pinwheel, but then in a resin flatback. You have to send me the link for these ones. These are so cute. Beautiful. Here's another one. So many details in the work of Wendy. If you already follow her, you know that. And if you're not, well, you should go over to her channel quickly. I will put a link in the description box. And subscribe to her channel and follow her on Instagram, because the inspiration is endless that she gives. Wow. Ah, oh, these are so cute. Gorgeous. We go on, because there are still some things left in the box. She really spoiled me. Here is a memory decks card. We did agree on a memory decks card. I made one in a circus theme, if you remember. With the garden party paper, which was in the circus theme. And she did a real garden party one. Look. Again, she added a shaker in the background that she did with the tulle that she stitched on the hard die cut. The beautiful swan. Yeah, a lot of layers. Beautiful dangle here with some small little beads. Butterfly. I love this. Really cute. You look so good in my memory deck tray. Oh, you see, I'm already at 20 minutes, so I really cannot show you the journal in this video. Then we go to this box. This box I will keep closed. It's a really nice die. You can rip it open, but I'm not going to do that right now. And again, she gifted me some gorgeous flowers. Or also vellum and combined paper with vellum, but then in a smaller scale. We all remember this die. I have it as well. It's such a cute decoration. Really beautiful. And a fabric bow on top. Really sweet. I will hang this in my craft room. I have something like this from Heike, and I will hang it to that with that. It will look so cute together here. Here is another package she made. Again, gorgeous back topper. She made one of the pockets again that she already gifted me one in the challenge entry. I can put this into a journal or on a card, whatever. I really loved it. She even attached a small little tassel here. Cute bows. Beautiful flower with a piece that is for jewelry making. Love it. Thank you. Then we go to the next pack. Again, Mylar. You also need to tell me where you found this. This is also beautiful. She used this also on her planner or on her junk journal. I loved it. Here she added the paper doily with the girl from the garden party collection. And this is an envelope with, again, closes with Velcro. Look how beautiful. And yeah. She spoiled me with a lot of thin shakers that she made. Look, she made them all thin. I love it with the tulle, so I can use them for layering on my own projects. Thank you, Wendy. I love this. You know that I don't like to make those, and but I do like to use them, so gorgeous. Really happy you made those for me, so I can decorate them myself. Look how cute. And I do know how much time they take to make, so really nice of you to take the time to make them for me. Then we go to this gorgeous bag that was in it. I did not open this, so it's a surprise for me what's on the inside of this. But look how beautiful this bag is. She used a bow on top, a large bow, and she made it from some kind of faux leather or fabric with daisies on it. Really beautiful, and it matched the garden party paper so well. Cute dangle, some tulle. I recognized it. It's from Dollar Tree, so it was probably gifted to her as well. She lives in the Netherlands, so she doesn't have access to a Dollar Tree. So let's open it and look what's on the inside. Oh my god, she stuffed it with stuff. I have to take the ribbon off, otherwise I cannot take everything out. And let's see. Oh, that's cute. Oh, thank you. This is so cute. Look. She made some kind of a wand with a stick for in the garden to tell you which plants you have with your seeds. But look, she added my Instagram name on it. Brigje05 is my Instagram handle. Oh, this is so cute. I can put this in my YouTube videos, and then they can see where you can find me on Instagram. This is so thoughtful of you. I really loved it. She layered it beautifully with the bow, and again, stickers from the garden party. Gorgeous. Thank you so much. This is so cute. Then, again, some Really dainty ribbon tassels. I don't have trims this tiny, I think. Really beautiful, and she added charms to it. Gorgeous. Wow. Oh, these are so cute. Look, it's an ice cream container. I love this. And everything is decorated with Garden Party. She taped it really well, so I'm not going to take it out. You can see what's on the inside. A lot of the beautiful layered butterflies she also used on my on this. I love it. Thank you. Ah, oh, this is so cute. And look, also a cute candy jar. Ah, with the sequin mix matching the Garden Party collection. I love it. And we're still not here. I have to do this. She included a lot of, look, cute wooden spools that she did paint herself, I think. And she attached some cute ribbon for me to use. And we have a few more on the inside. Beautiful green ribbon. This looks so cute on the small painted wooden ribbon spools. Beautiful gold trim on a white one. And this one, yeah. Well, this is this cute ribbon on this one. I will put it back after the video. And again, also attached to this bag is a gorgeous dangle. She attached dangles to everything. Look how cute. I just love it. So beautiful. I will put it here. Yeah, it's too much to show you in one frame. But yeah, I will make pictures afterwards, of course. And then we go to the last thing that I'm going to show you in this video. And that's this beautiful embellishment box that she did. Again, it opened, so I did do a lot of digging because it contained so many small items. I didn't want to miss anything, but I think I found them all. And look how she decorated the front, really beautiful. Love this frame, gorgeous flower again. It's so beautiful. And let's open it. And there are a lot of things on the inside. I'm not going to show you everything, because that will all only take me a half hour. But she did include some pins for me, like I did with her. Really sweet. Also, some beautiful wax seals. This one I have as well. She does them also really gorgeous. She made it some cute little of the ring embellishments, the ring dangles. So sweet. This one I love as well. I think this one is by a tutorial from Pucci Tats. It's a cute arrow. Hugs. I really like these. I think I can recreate these as well for Valentine's Day. I have similar items. Then she did a whole lot of bead wrapping for me. On the inside are a lot of these. She did make dangles with, how do you call this? The small beads and with the sequins. And look at her bead wrapping, her wire wrapping. Mine does not look so good. There are a whole lot of them in this package. I'm not going to show them all to you, but she did wire wrap a whole bunch. I saw this one, really cute. I love this one. Seen this before, but I don't think I have any. Also, in the box came a lot of cute flare buttons that I can use. Love these as well. She did include some bottle caps with the things that you can put on the inside to cover your image with. Yeah, there is so much to see in this box. It's not normal. Again, look how she did a lot of those. She really spoiled me. And yeah, as I said, I cannot go through them all because it would be too long, but you can take a look at it. She really spoiled me. Not normal. Here is a wax seal with a bee. I don't have a bee one. Also so cute. And look how her wax seals look. They look awesome. Awesome, awesome. Another one. Wow, wow, wow. Wendy, thank you for all this gorgeousness in this swap. I love, love, love it. You really spoiled me. I'm so honored that I have, again, some beautiful creations of me, of you. I follow you for quite some time now, and you inspire me so much. You are a really sweet person to talk to. We talk on Instagram sometimes, and yeah, she's so sweet. And yeah, it's really nice to speak to a fellow crafty Dutchie, and yeah, a person with the same hobby as you, or with the same craze as you. That's so nice. And again, she's so talented. Go over to her channel, give her a subscription, and follow her on Instagram as well. Yeah, now I see this all. I think I did not do enough for you, but yeah, I will make it up to you sometime. And stay tuned for my other video that I will make of the gorgeous junk journal she did. And keep in your head, first junk journal she ever made. She told me she got a lot of help from Pink Paper Daisy, and she did a great job making this journal with the help of her. So I hope you will be back for my next video. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.